Thanks to Alkene for sponsoring this video and making it possible to learn organic chemistry in an interactive way. Here are some important keywords to help you understand this mechanism and the others that follow. We'll start with the difference between a nucleophile and electrophile. You know something is a nucleophile because it has electrons or a negative charge, while an electrophile will have a partial or full positive charge. A nucleophile will donate a pair of electrons, while an electrophile will accept a pair of electrons. Remember that electrons flow from nucleophile to electrophile. Protonation is the addition of a proton. A proton refers to H+. And a pi bond simply refers to a double bond. Here's a generic hydrohalogenation mechanism where X represents one of these halogens. The reaction starts with the nucleophile, which is our pi bond, grabbing the electrophile, which is our hydrogen, since it has a partial positive charge, and electrons flow from nucleophile to electrophile. Our hydrogen now goes to one of the carbons that was a part of the double bond, and the other carbon is positively charged since we lost electrons. This positively charged carbon is known as a carbocation. Since the hydrogen is taken, the electrons in this bond will now go to the halogen, which results in a negative charge since the halogen just gained electrons. Since this alkene was symmetrical, it does not matter where the hydrogen or carbocation goes, whether it's this carbon or the other. But if an alkene is not symmetrical, then it does matter where the hydrogen and carbocation goes. This video, which I'll link up right now, goes over what to do when an alkene is not symmetrical. Continuing on. What happens next in this reaction is called a nucleophilic attack. This is where our new nucleophile, which is the halogen, attacks the carbocation and attaches onto that carbon to give us our product. Here's a common hydrohalogenation example. This double bond, or pi bond, is our nucleophile, and the hydrogen is our electrophile. Where students make the most mistakes is by not understanding how electrons move and what's happening to each atom. That's why we'll be using the Mechanisms app, because it's literally designed to help you avoid these mistakes. If you would like to follow along with me, you can. The link to download this app is in the description. For this example that we're doing, it is in the Essentials pack, which is free, and it's under the third section under Addition. It's number one. So step one, protonation. This is where the electrons in the double bond reach out and grab the hydrogen. Since the hydrogen is being taken away from the bromine, the electrons in this bond now go to bromine. For the carbons that have the double bond, one carbon is now the carbocation and the other has the hydrogen. Step two is a nucleophilic attack on the carbocation. Our bromine is now negatively charged and will act as our new nucleophile. The electrons from the bromine will attack the carbocation and form a new bond, which results in our product for this reaction. The Mechanisms app even shows you the steps you need to take for each type of reaction. Here, we see there are only two steps. One was protonation of the carbon in the double bond, or we can state this as the deprotonation of HBr, meaning we remove the hydrogen from HBr. The second one was our nucleophilic attack on the carbocation. Now that you know the basics, let's get to the questions that will be on your test. You will most likely be tested on a carbon chain that isn't symmetrical. Before you click on the next video, try this question out on the Mechanisms app. The link to download this app is in the description. And this question is part of their free Essentials pack. It is in the third section under Addition. It's number five. And I'll see you in the next video, where we'll cover what to do with a non-symmetrical alkene and understand Markovnikov's rule.